Dale, you look gorgeous. Unbelievable tonight. This is so delicate, we couldn't even put your little microphone back on, could we?
No.
Because that's how delicate this is. Is it delicate from the back, Jules?
Enchantingly delicate.
Right, good. You sure? That was the Sheep Sheep song. Right. What is a sheep, Cher?
I don't know.
We don't know what a sheep is. We see them, we don't
like
know.
A lang-a-lang, a ding-dong, or a doo-wop.
Well, there you are, you yeah. See? That's what a sheep is like, the lang-a-lang ding-dong.
Right.
Now, normally when
very
we have...
Very rare, too.
Is it?
Yes.
Right, okay.
There's only a couple of sheeps left.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, we better take care of them in that case, hadn't we?
Right.
Good. Now, normally we have, when we have stars on, you know, yes. And you're the biggest star we've ever had on the show, there's no doubt about that. We have a chant from the audience every time I say your name.
Okay.
But because you are the biggest star we've ever had on, and I don't mind saying even now, you're probably the biggest star we're going to ever have on, don't you think so, yeah?
Yeah!
You see, next week we've got Ken Dodd, so I'm not sure. We're going to let you choose. We've got three chants, and you can choose from one of those chants, okay? Now, normally people don't get to choose, but you can choose your own chant. And they've got them ready for you, the audience.
Okay.
Can you give us chant number one, please? It's not fair, you're gorgeous, Cher.
Okay.
You like that one?
Well, it's not bad.
Okay. Chant number two. Okay?
All right.
Basic, but effective.
Right.
Now, are you ready for this one?
Yeah.
Because I don't think the audience are. Chant number three. Cher, we love your hair. So which one do you prefer?
I like number one.
Number one it is, okay. So from now on, when I say your name, they will reply. Okay, so tonight's hero, Cher. There you go, you're lumbered with that one. Now, on Monday, of course, in America, it's the Oscar ceremonies, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
Are you going to be back for those?
No, I'm not.
You're not going to be part of them this year?
No.
Because you have actually won an Oscar, haven't you?
Yeah.
Yeah, we not only... And not only any Oscar, but Best Actress.
Yeah.
Which is going to be the best one for you to win, hasn't it, really?
Well, yeah.
Well, you could have been Best Supporting Actress, but you've got the Best Actress.
I was nominated for Best Supporting Actress. I lost.
Who cares? You won the Best Actress.
That's
there you
true.
Are. And isn't it true that if you win the Best Actress, you have to go back the next year to perform a special task?
You have to present next year to the Best Actor.
So not only has she won an Oscar, but she's presented one, and she can sing, and she can dance, and she looks beautiful. So, Cher, if you presented awards, would you mind terribly presenting an award for us this evening? Would you mind?
Sure, what the hell?
Okay. Well, Cher says sure, you know, you can't go wrong. So here we go. We have the gold envelope, and there you go. There's all the information.
This is the award for the best audience member.
Right.
And the nominations are from Essex, Janet Jennings.
Croydon.
Okay. And from Croydon, Julie Watson. And the winner is... Well, they're easier at the Oscars.
I'm sorry about it. We've never done it before. We don't have it in England.
All right, and the winner is... Julie Watson from Croydon.
There you go.
There's
the super
short.
There you go,
Judy. Yeah,
you've
done
a superior job.
There you go.
Thank you. You have to make your speech.
Yeah.
Oh, man, I'm really embarrassed now. Thanks so much. This is great. And don't forget your toothbrush.
Okay, thank you, Julie. We'll go play the Superman quiz now. Okay, you go over here.
Tonight's Superman is 20-year-old student teacher Sean Walker from Coventry.
This one's okay for now. Okay, and here is Cher's Superman. There you go, there's Sean. Round of applause for Sean, please, if you don't mind. Tonight's Superman is Sean Walker. Welcome to the show. This is the part of the show, of course, where we... Who knows more about Cher? Cher, or, in fact, her superfan, Sean. Sean's from Coventry, 20 years old. You're a student. How long have you been a Cher fan?
Oh, for about 6 or 7 years.
About 6 or 7 years. So. And how did you get into Cher, so to speak?
I found someone.
You found someone?
I found someone.
You found Cher?
Yeah.
There you are. And where did you hear that record? Was it at a club or
on
the radio?
On the radio.
On the radio. And that was it for you? Okay. In love, smitten. And he's become a true fan. There's this photograph here. Tell us the story about this photograph, Sean.
Come on, tell us a story.
Come on.
Well, that's in Cher's hotel room. Cher went shopping.
I bought a whole bunch of wigs, and we came back, and we just had them all over the floor, and we tried them on, and he took that picture.
Hey, there you are, you see. True story. And this is also a jacket that Cher actually, she says she gave it to him, but we know she sold this jacket to Sean. No, she didn't. She gave it to
him. It was a present to him.
Okay, for being such a fan.
Yeah.
And is this your most prized possession?
It is.
Apart from, of course, being on the show with her right now. Ready to play the game?
Yep.
Sure.
Okay, it's very simple. Of course, before we play, though, it's not just about pride, it's about personal possessions. Because Sean's brought something for Cher if she wins, and Cher's brought something for Sean if she wins. And try saying that on a Saturday. Right. Sean, what have you brought for Cher?
I brought this.
Okay. But what is it, Sean?
This is the first thing I made in primary school. And I've had it since I was 5.
Isn't that a beautiful thing? Okay, and Cher, what have you brought for Sean?
Well, I haven't had it since I was 5, but I brought it.
Okay, Chef. What are they?
What are they?
Yes.
You don't know what they
no,
are, Chris?
I don't know
are.
What
they it's a G-string.
There you are.
So, here.
Okay, and you told us an interesting fact about a G-string and knickers, didn't you?
There's a difference, because panties have the front on both sides, it's the same width, and a G-string has just got that little bit in the back.
There you are. A lesson in G-strings and undies. Okay, you ready to play?
Yeah.
Okay, it's a quick fire 2-minute round, and as in all the best quiz shows, I'm going out with the hostess. There you are. Okay, and your 2 minutes starts now. What year did Cher win her Oscar for Moonstruck? Sean.
88.
87 is the answer. How many weeks was the Sheep Sheep song at number 1 in the UK? Sean.
5.
Is the correct answer. What is Cher's real name? Sean.
Sherilyn Sarkisian.
Sherilyn?
Sarkisian.
Stop the clock, please, because is that right, Cher?
Yeah.
We didn't actually know the answer to that when we just told you. Okay. For which 60s group did Cher sing vocals? Cher.
Ronette.
Is the correct answer. Which singer made his US TV debut on Cher's show for CBS? Which British singer, very famous, Grand Control to make
David
the song.
Bowie.
It's the correct answer, in 1975, singing Fame. How old was Cher when she had a brace fitted to her teeth? Cher.
30-something.
37 is the answer. Stop the clock. Stop the clock. Cher, why did you have a brace fitted at 37? Usually it's a juvenile kind of thing.
Well, because when I started doing movies, you know, my head, my front teeth, the two on the side, they stuck out, and the two in the middle, they went back, and when I started doing movies, the two in the middle started disappearing because of the lighting.
So, must have been hell.
Yes, it was.
Good. Okay, start the clock. Cher's hit Heart of Stone was originally written for which band? Sean.
Bucks
Fizz. Bucks Fizz is the answer. Who took the photo for the cover of Cher's greatest hits? Who took the photo? Sean.
Herbert.
It's the correct answer. Come on, Cher. The video for If I Could Turn Back Time was banned by which TV station? Sean.
MTV.
Yes, the correct answer.
But it wasn't really. That's not the truth.
Stop the clock. What?
It was banned after 9 weeks.
5 points off, Sean. 10 points on to Cher. What instrument did Cher's son Elijah play while on tour with Cher in 1990, Sean?
Guitar.
Which one? Sorry, it's not a full correct answer. Give the points to Cher anyway. How many tattoos does Cher have? Count them. Sean.
7.
Cher?
Wait.
6. I saw them earlier on. Okay. In the film, Witches of Eastwick, Cher wakes up in bed to find she's covered by what? Cher.
Snakes.
It's the correct answer. Who wrote and produced Cher's hit I Found Someone? Sean.
Michael Bolton.
Correct. Did you get on with him? Sean.
No.
Cher?
Sometimes.
Okay. What was Cher's first solo million-selling single? Cher.
All I Really Want to Do.
Bang Bang is the answer. What was the name of Cher's character in Mermaids? Cher.
I don't remember.
Rachel Flax is the answer. What colour dress did Cher wear for her cameo appearance in The Player? Cher.
Red.
Correct. What opera featured in Cher's film Moonstruck? Cher.
Oh, I don't remember.
La Bohème. Which song was the hit in the UK for Cilla Black, and Cher had a hit also in the US with it?